They say I'm crazy. The way you got me open, baby. Ooh. They say I'm bugging. The way I'm time sweating your loving. Ooh. They all sit and wonder why this feeling I cannot hide. It ain't a question of pride. Ooh. It's love, it's love, it's love, it's love. It's love, it's love, it's love. They say I'm tripping the way you got my whole life flipping. Ooh.
Good morning, good morning. It's the Tale of Love, Tales All, Love's Tragic Comedy Show. And we're here with the cast of Venus Meets Mars. We got Tracy Jackson over here. And I'm about to hit him in the face with the microphone.
Hello, don't do that.
We got Mr. Micah. And you know my bestie. That's
hello.
Water.
Hello.
So if you didn't know and you're tuning in for the first time for Venus Meets Mars, we having this segment every second Saturday of the month. We're going to have adult conversations between men and women. Wanda and I, of course, are representing Venus, and Tracy and Mr. Micah will represent Mars.
Some
off-brand planet.
Ebok, not with that.
Yeah. Martians.
Is that Mork and Mindy used to do that sign or something?
So today we're going to talk about children in your respective relationships. And I did get some inboxes and emails from some viewers, and we're going to chime in on what they feel and what their perspectives are as we move through this. So it's going to be like a three-part segment. And the first part is, are couples without children happier?
Wait, can I say something? Before we start this, I just want to say...
You want to say how cute I am?
Of course, and I love your new haircut.
Oh, thank you.
But a subject that really hits home for me, this month is Autism Awareness Month. So I've got my blue lighted up blue. I encourage everyone else to do the same. I have an autistic son, so please, everybody, if you could support, it would be great.
Okay.
Now, do we wear blue the whole month, or?
This the whole month.
Whenever to wear blue.
I don't expect you to be, cripping it out here.
Right. Yes.
Yeah. Whenever you can get a little blue, post it on Facebook to show your support on social media, it would be appreciated.
Okay. Well,
all right. So, are couples without children happier?
Well, when you talk about stuff like that, I don't think you could say all or none. You have some couples who probably are happier without children because they have a little more freedom.
Mm-hmm.
But then you have couples who love kids. I love kids. So if I didn't have any kids, I wouldn't be as happy because I love kids.
Why does Megatron get two mics? Which one are you speaking into, dog?
He's from Mars. Remember, he's from Mars.
What you say, Eric? This one?
I'm talking.
He's from Mars, so he's got
Dr.
That.
Octopus over there. Yeah.
But on that question, are couples happier without children? It depends on the age. Now, if they're young, I think you're at an age where you're getting to know each other. You're young. Maybe you really don't need kids in a relationship. I said from 20 maybe to 25 because you're learning to deal with yourself, maybe working. That's just my opinion. And if you're talking about couples that are older, say, they got met later and nobody had kids and they get married or something, it depends, I think, on the situation and what age frame you're talking about. But if you grow together and you're young and you start off in a relationship and then later on, say, you have kids together because you already developed your foundation of what a home is going to be and that kind of stuff, then you bring kids into it later, then you appreciate because you have both sides. Now, for me, I jumped in the frying pan. So I had kids young, marriage young. So it wasn't like I got to experience adulthood, really, as being in a relationship and we learning each other and kids came in later. The kids was there. So that's my opinion.
I think it's just a preference. I mean, there are some couples who don't want kids at all. Right. It doesn't matter what age you are.
That's right.
What position you are in your life, they just never, you know, wanted kids. And then there are some that, you know, even older, in their 40s and 50s and still may want to have another one. So I think it just depends on the couple. We can't say across the board, you know, if couples are generally happier with or without.
Now,
it just depends on the demeanor.
We all have kids here at the table.
Right.
So
I
want
to address something. I'm sorry. I want to address something. And it might be totally off subject. And we can table it to come back. But I think it was an issue when you said, like, a couple between 20 and 25. I don't even think you should be a couple at that age, because you're still enjoying being a young person out here dating and everything. You know, I mean, again, it's to the person, because, you know, you have some people, you know, you have these stories of people who met college sweethearts and were married for 40, 50 years. That's great. That's not for everybody. But at 20, I can speak for myself. At 20,
you
to 25,
ready.
No, wasn't going to happen.
I thought I was, but I really wasn't.
God said I was ready, so hey.
And then, you know, with females, a lot of people tend to think just because you're a female, you're maternal, you want to have kids, your biological clock is ticking, you're pressed to shoot this baby out. For me, I never wanted kids. I do have, was blessed to have two of them. And so when I went into my relation, I wanted to be single and just do me forever. So, but when I got married, you know, the men that I chose wanted children. And I said, well, you know, I really didn't want any, but if I have them, you know, for you, then be sure your ass is going to get up at 2, 4, 6, and 8 to feed their ass. So anyway, but I love my children. And
they survive.
Right, and they live through it. But you have to have real conversations with whomever you're getting with, because I know not a lot of females, but some females, they just don't want children. And people don't, you know, they look at you some kind of way.
Yeah,
when,
like,
you're a female,
what?
They don't want children.
Right.
You don't want
but
kids?
That also, that conversation that you had, remember segments ago I spoke about,
You always bringing up some shit I said last.
No, it was something I said. Something I said segments ago. And I think in our initial Venus Meets Mars, I was saying when you get involved in that relationship, there's a conversation to be had.
Right.
That's in that conversation. Mm-hmm. Do you want kids? No.
And
I
now.
Do.
So,
and
now.
Right. You know, right up front.
Well, I'll say this. When I got married, that was a conversation my ex and I had before we got married. She had a child.
Mm-hmm.
And she didn't want any more kids.
Mm-hmm.
And I wanted kids. So that was something we had to talk about. Okay. Because, I mean, it would be nothing against her, but if she said she didn't want any kids, then I would be like, well, you know what? This is not going to work for me.
Right.
Because I want kids. A child, children, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So sometimes it happens like that.
Well, let me read something one of our viewers sent in by email. My husband and I decided before we got married not to have children. We don't worry about babysitters. We don't worry about college funds. And every night is date night. Okay. All right.
But that's a preference. Like you said, that's their preference. For them. They don't want any kids. They don't have that responsibility of having to worry about finding a babysitter. And that's fine. You know, and to each his own. That's the same thing I say to people who get these little dogs.
Don't talk about me.
That's like having another child.
It is.
You go out and leave it. And
but
that's
it's different.
No, it's not.
It's a little different.
It ain't different.
It is different.
That's a little different.
The difference is that dog never grows up, so you can never start leaving them at home. When your child gets a certain age, you can be like, I'm gone.
No.
Well,
the difference
it's a big difference.
Your child will grow up to that age where you leave him alone, the dog will just die by then. So either way.
And plus, I ain't got to worry about college with the dog. They not talking.
But what
back,
I will say is,
dating, jail.
The couples that say they don't want kids, right, they don't have to worry about that to this couple.
Right.
All right, so then that brings to mind, what measures are you taking not to make sure that this doesn't happen?
I was getting right, yeah. So, y'all using protection.
So if you don't have any kids, it's really hard to find a doctor that will give you a vasectomy. Or tie your tubes.
Right.
So
which
now
I
that means
they
that they're using
birth control. You can take a pill and get an IUD
or something. Now we get into stuff like, this ain't even fun.
It ain't even date night.
I'm speaking for myself. Well, no, not for y'all. I'm just saying.
I mean, I hear what you're saying. But like I said, I think it all, and we're all saying the same thing about it. And we're going around, we're saying up a little bit. But it's a preference thing. If this couple is happy not having kids and like their freedom, which I understand.
Mm-hmm.
I understand. I do think every couple should have that time.
you should have a time where you're a couple and you're getting to know each other. You can have those date nights and time to just get to know each other or just be with each other. And then the children come late. Now, we all know that that's not always the way it happens.
Right, right.
But, I mean, it's a preference. Some people want to be with their kids. Some people want to be alone. And it's just...
They sound like they got a bug out bag waiting. Hey. If something happened, we out.
We out the door. I mean,
this couple. Because they don't have any kids. They got bags by the door. Like, you want to go to Italy? We out.
Right. I thought you was taking care of that. But you know, like you said, it really is a choice. And you know, I survived it, and it was okay, and it worked out probably for the best in my situation that I did have some, because Lord knows where I'd be right now.
Well, I will say this: I have kids. I don't think I've ever had a time where it really bothered me that I had to, you know, stay in with my children or couldn't do this, because I mean, I've always been able to. I mean, you find a way. Mm-hmm. You have fun, but it's never been a burden for me. So I would probably
you
be
you never unhappy. Had to breastfeed at 2 o'clock in the damn morning.
I didn't either. I wasn't breastfeeding.
Just because I didn't have to breastfeed, that didn't mean I didn't get up and
get a bottle, right?
I would probably, and this is just me, I would probably be more unhappy without kids in my life. Okay. And that's just me.
And I kind of would agree with you.
Me too. And I think having kids has made me a better person, even though I went into it reluctantly in the beginning. But I think it has made me.
Well, you just shooting them down every single
day. Who?
I didn't want them, but I got
them.
Somebody's right now listening, Mom.
Oh, they know how and I love my children to death. But you know, I just had a plan when I was growing up to travel around the world and just be free and single, and that was my mindset.
Somebody else had a bigger and better plan.
When I was, you know, growing up from childhood until I got married, pretty much. And so it wasn't like I hate children. I just wanted to do what I wanted to do, and it was travel the world. And I went around the world, and I made 2 kids while I was around the world. So I got it all done.
Okay. Comment allez-vous. Okay.
So we're going to switch. We're still on children, but now
that's a good one right there.
Disciplining your significant other's kids or them disciplining yours.
It's going to be problems.
So, I mean...
I think it's a sticky subject.
It is.
Again, you go back to this conversation. First of all, let me say this. I think communication is the biggest part of any relationship. Any relationship at all. So you have to talk to each other about everything. If we're together, I'm not just talking about I see you sometimes, whatever. If we're living together, we're in a relationship, a committed relationship, we're living together, and my child is living with us and your child is living with us, then I should be able to discipline your child.
I agree.
And then you should be able to discipline my child. But I also think that we should talk about things.
Mm-hmm.
If you start saying, well, your child did this, my child, it's going to cause a rift. I don't think that's good for anything. So I think the communication should be there. I think that the parents should talk to each other when concerning the discipline.
Right.
Well, that's a perfect world. And really, if you're in a relationship with somebody like a man, he has kids and they come over every other weekend.
Because
evidently, he's not with the baby's mama if you're dating. Yeah. So the kids come over every weekend, they're jumping around, and most likely the woman has to cook breakfast, lunch, dinner, plan activities so you can get them out the house. If they're playing in the yard, and you know, whose house are you coming to? They're just jumping around. See, I discipline all kids. If I see kids doing something, I'll be like, hey, get down, Johnny. Sit your butt down. Go on outside and play. Wipe your feet. Wash your hands. You know, you tell them that. All kids.
But that's not the discipline I'm talking about. We had that neighborhood growing up. Where I grew up in my neighborhood, any parent that saw you doing anything would do that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that's not the discipline. I'm talking about...
You talking about whipping that butt?
Well, putting something down. I mean, sit... If I see
time out,
your child jack jumping
up
on my sofa, get off my sofa. I don't care what we talk about. He's not going to do that.
Yeah.
But I'm talking about if we're together and this child does something wrong. I mean, coming in with school grades, different things. When you're together, you know, I'm not going to sit by and say, your child comes in, he gets all Fs, And then you, I say, what we're doing this weekend? You say, well, we're going to take Johnny out to get some new shoes. No, we're not.
Well, yeah, I agree with that.
But no, you agree with it, but yeah, you have some people who don't.
Oh, right.
Some people say,
that's
well,
my
right.
child.
Well, that's what I'm saying. I'm going to take my, so whoa, that's a problem.
Yeah,
so
that is a problem.
The communication has to be there. And when it comes back down to it, it's something you have to talk about, and it's a preference. I mean, some people might say, well, you deal with yours.
And I'll deal with mine. And that's hard.
It can be, but for some people it works.
I think that's a recipe for disaster.
I do too.
Yeah. The way I feel like when you go into a relationship like that and you have to discipline someone, and I say have to because and when you're in that little bond, it has to be.
It has to.
So you have to talk to the kid one, mm-hmm. right? Let's just say, for example, if I'm dating a woman and she has a little boy, he's 7, and you tell him, he's like, look, man, hey, your mom and I are together. I don't know how you feel about that. Mm-hmm. I'm not trying to be your dad. You have a father, right? But
hopefully
you will respect the things and the rules of my house.
Mm-hmm.
So that has to take place, and I think she has to be on board with mm-hmm. that, he or she, and then the other parent. That's right. Not in the relationship has to be because you know just
oh,
like
yeah,
I know.
They go home and say, "Mr.
And
Micah,"
then, right? And then he come over there and be like, "What you doing disciplining my son, dog?" And I'm like, right. "I discipline you for real, dog. if you really want to
okay.
go back."
I agree. I totally. The other parent, not the other parent who's not in house. I'm talking about the couple.
Mm-hmm.
They have to be on the same plane.
Mm-hmm.
If I do something, and you don't agree, I can't discipline your child. Without you being on board with
right.
me, because now I'm the bad guy.
Right, and
I look like right. I'm the mean one. And
well, it depends what kind of discipline. Any kind.
I'm gonna tell
one
you
person
from
can't
the smallest thing. If you and I are together and your child does anything, I mean, because some things you're gonna think is okay, and I might not agree with it. So if I say something about it and we're not on the same plane about it, you're gonna be like, well, what's wrong with him doing that?
Right.
Now, that should never be done in front of the child.
Right, right.
But always if we're not on the same plane, maybe we need to talk about, well, he always does this and that. Well, Tracy, I don't think there's anything wrong with that. We have to come to something. So next time I see him doing it, I might have to just be like.
Yeah, I had to let that go because it might not be. But I don't believe in spanking.
No, boy.
Look, Tracy said so I don't know if yet. I would.
Tap that ass.
Yeah.
Like a keg.
I don't know. It depends, and then that's the subject. That's what really you need to have the conversation.
That's a conversation.
You gonna put your hands on my child, or are you gonna talk to him?
Right.
And it depends on the age. Now, speaking of boys, for an example, say the boy is from 10 to 13, 14. Let's say his father is not in the picture. Mm-hmm. So then, as a couple, I'm really looking for you to help me raise my son.
But
it depends on your mentality and what you want to do to help him.
Right.
There's a couple things. One we're omitting is age, right?
Yeah.
Now, I've been in a relationship with someone who had a 17, 18-year-old
ooh.
Child. At that point, it's really too late. There's nothing I really can do with that child. Because
that's like baby boy movie day.
She was on her way to college.
Oh,
you know
it was
what
a
mean?
Girl.
Right.
Okay.
She was on her
and
way
that's
to college.
A difference
so
to me.
She had been raised pretty much already.
Right.
If she had did something wrong, let's say she went out and got drunk or whatever,
mm-hmm.
her mother has to deal with that. I don't feel like at this point that's something that I should step in and be
mm-hmm.
like. Now, she came to our house, and this is a blanket statement. Don't bring your kids to my house if you don't want them disciplined. I don't care who you are. You're not
mm-hmm.
going to run amok in my house. So
mm-hmm.
if Johnny's running around and he's got my CD
right.
on the wall like this,
oh, no.
I'm going to tell you one time,
Johnny
I'm going to be like, you better
go.
Get Johnny or else I'm
yeah.
about to pop that ass.
Yeah, I'm with you on that. Johnny got to go.
Right.
Now, as far as we're talking about the older children, there's no discipline in them because they're pretty much grown.
Right.
But I do think you could take it in amongst yourselves and you talk to her and say, hey, look, you know, a young lady like yourself getting drunk like that, you
mm-hmm.
can talk to her. You can,
oh yeah,
you know
yeah,
what I'm
yeah.
saying?
You
talk,
definitely
that's
still a father
right.
figure.
That's not.
But
a,
I don't think it's discipline.
No, that's not a discipline
right there
thing.
Is just trying to steer
show
her.
Show some
right
concern,
right there.
And they got their booty shorts on, midriff coming in.
And then you
like,
tell
hey.
Them what the real deal is.
You
like,
can.
Look, Shorty.
I'm gonna
yeah.
tell you this.
Yep.
Now, when you're saying this age with the 10 to 12, I don't. If you're looking for him to help you raise, I don't think there's anything wrong with that. But again, I want to go back to, don't make him the bad guy. What I mean by that is if little Johnny does something and you want me to discipline him And then once I discipline him, he runs
to
you.
I don't like how you did it.
No, not even that. He runs to you, and you are, it's okay. No. You got what you deserve. Now he looks like whenever something bad happens, it's here. And then when he wants to do something, well, you say, well, go ask Tracy. Because you don't want to tell him no. So you know when he comes to me, I'm going to be like, no. He's going to be like, he's the bad guy. Mm-hmm. He never lets me do anything. Mm-hmm. And you never say, well, I don't want you to do it either. I don't think you should do it. You just be like, well, now I'm the bad guy. I don't think you can do it.
And I think it's always important when you start these serious relationships and there are children that they sit down and talk to the kid about what's happening. And the other person, the not the biological person, they have to have come with some kindness too. It can't always be about you did something wrong. You gotta, stroke them sometimes.
You have to bond with them.
Right. You stepping into their lives and they're like, okay, who is this Joe or who is this lady? And so, you have to build those relationships just like you build the adult relationships. But I'm going to read something from a viewer. Okay, it says, my wife does not let me discipline her son. He's 16 now, and I've been in his life since he was a baby. She told me it's him and her against me. Whoa. My advice is it's been 16 years y'all been dealing with this, and you've been sitting in the basement
an altercation, because what's going to happen is that 16-year-old now has got testosterone flowing through him like crazy. Right. So he's going to jump up thinking he's bad, and now this man is left. The man is left in a precarious situation. He's going to have to fuck him up. There's a point in every young man's life where he tests that adult.
Yeah, you right.
I did it to
that.
My father, and he fucked me up.
Yeah, and my son. Your ass down.
Yeah, showed me what a real man was about, and I'm sure my son will do it. And I got something waiting for him.
Well, I'm gonna tell you. I'm gonna say this about that situation right there. Mm-hmm. He's 16. He's been in his life since he was a baby.
Yeah,
and this has been going on.
Mm-hmm.
It's too late.
Yeah, it is.
At this point, it's a wrap. If she's saying it's he and I
against you,
it's a wrap. Send her and him out somewhere else and start over.
Can a relationship be repaired? You think it's if the son is getting older and he's getting ready to leave the house? Let's say
no, because she has the wrong mentality.
That's right.
For her to even say it's me and my son against you. That right there is not even conducive to a healthy relationship.
I agree.
I'm just saying, if because say the son is getting ready to leave, you already married, and he's getting ready to go to college, 18.
Mm-hmm.
You think there can kind of
the husband and the wife?
Because if he's still there, he must have some love or something.
But you just respected me as the man. The wife has disrespected me for 16 years.
That's a whole different situation.
Yeah, right,
but okay, let's go with that scenario you said. He's 16. He's getting ready to go away to college. He's having this battle right here.
Mm-hmm.
He goes away to college. Everything's fine. You still got spring break. You still got the summer. So when he comes home, and he comes up in there, and it goes back to that dynamic.
Y'all assuming he's going away to college.
We're assuming that.
Right.
In her perfect world.
Right.
Let him go away to school. But when he comes home, you're going to still have that dynamic again. You don't, we're going to go from being lovey-dovey and having everything great to when he comes in, this 16, 17-year-old's going to run my house?
I don't care if he was in California.
He's
still going to call his mother and say, Mom, guess what? I got a DUI last night.
Oh, yeah.
Right? And the mom is going to do this, that, and that. And then the man is going to say something. And she's like, what the hell are you talking about? That's my son. You stay the hell out of it.
Yeah.
He still can cause friction from 500 miles or 200 miles away or wherever.
Right, yeah.
So I don't think it really makes a difference.
My advice to him is get out. Enjoy the rest of your senior years.
Get out.
It's too late.
Join me in Leisure World. We can play checkers together.
Shuffleboard or whatever.
We can't say that, though, about that man's marriage. That's fucked up.
I'm talking about the situation. He asked.
Yeah.
I didn't touch it.
You got to move it towards this way because it's kind of
bad. It's not on the thing.
It's got that long.
It's all right. It's good. It wasn't on
that. The cord is caught up.
Hand that long stick on
it. Oh, boy.
Okay, wow.
Take charge of your apparatus.
That's a whole different show. Okay. That's a whole different show.
Okay, I have another one. It says, I don't have a problem with my boyfriend disciplining my son. My problem is that he ignores him. So Johnny's jumping up and down, Sharpie pens all over.
How do you discipline somebody but you're ignoring them? Like she sticks him on him. Like you see him over there.
I think what she's saying, she wants him to
jump in, jump in, do something.
She's probably asked him, you know, help me out. And he's like,
that's your kid.
Right.
I mean,
I'm right. What do you do?
Get out.
It comes back to the communication thing. I mean, she should go to him and say, look, just like you were saying, if you have that son and you want this man to help you raise, she needs to go to him and say, you know, I need your help. I want your help in doing this. It might not be his thing.
Yeah.
Now, does he have any kids?
Right.
He might not ever wanted kids. You know what I'm saying?
Right, same thing,
that might have been that
Kid. But then that's also on him. Then he shouldn't have got into that relationship.
That's that communication. Yeah, with a kid. I agree. He might have got
But it's so good.
He might have got in for one thing.
And then I keep you around for a little call or something, but no.
That's what I'm saying.
Because
you ain't staying in there.
Right now, I would not get into a relationship with anyone who had a kid under probably 15.
Oh, we going to wait a minute.
I'm not dealing with any small children.
We getting to that shortly.
I don't even want grown. No. At least they at the house. Okay.
I got another one. This was a long one. I'm a single parent of two boys, ages 9 and 13. I have been in a monogamous relationship with this man for 4 years. While I totally trust and love this man with all of my heart, and my boys have established a good relationship with him, I still play the part of mom and dad, especially when it comes to discipline. My sons don't see their biological father, so my boyfriend is the main male role in their lives. Am I wrong for not wanting him to discipline my children?
Yes.
Across
flat
the
out,
board.
Flat out, yes.
Yeah. And y'all been together for 4 years, and the father isn't there. And see, the thing I find, and with me as well, I'm not going to say all women, we tend to step into another lane as the male person. And
you can only do what somebody lets you, though.
Right. But I'm saying, as women, sometimes we can't be in control of the whole thing. We want a man that's going to be strong. We want a man that can take charge. But yet, when it comes
But my point is, if he was truly strong, he wouldn't let you do it.
That's true,
That's
too.
My point. Okay. If he really was that strong of a person, you wouldn't step into that lane, because I'd hold you. Hold up. I got this. This is my realm of stuff right here. Just like we talked about being a protector, being this, that, and other. I got this.
Well, I agree with you to a certain extent. If I'm coming into her life with her children, again, is she allowing him to step in? It could be a battle. You can say, I'm going to do this.
Tracy, there ain't no allowing shit.
It is. It is.
You in my house, dog. You going to do what I... Or else we get ready to split.
But that's what I'm saying. I'm talking about that situation right there. She said that he's been in her life...
For four years.
Now, did she say they were married?
No. They said
committed relationship.
Okay,
monogamous.
So we don't know if they're living together.
Right.
We don't know if they're living together.
Right. That's true.
He's part of her life and her part of her children's life. We don't know if
he's full time.
He tried to do that, and then she was like,
gave him
no.
pump to break. Well, you're right.
You're right. What you're saying, if you're in my house, when I say my house, we're paying.
But when y'all living together, it's our house.
Right. Well, that's what I'm saying. My stake in it is not saying that in its entirety. It's my stake in this house. And as the man, I'm saying, though, you can't do this. But to your point, yeah, you're right. We're assuming, but if she keeps him totally home and never brings him to his house, I don't got to discipline him. That's fine. You keep him home, move him over there. But it's the second we merge, right? Or you step into my house, all bets is off.
what I'm noticing here is a lot of these questions are coming. They've been in a relationship for some time.
And
after a certain point, it's too late.
Yeah.
I mean, these are things you have to establish early
on. Right, exactly.
If we come into a relationship and you have children, I don't care how old they are, and from the beginning we don't talk about it or anything, and you just let it go. Sometimes now it goes into a natural flow and it works.
Mm-hmm.
But I think you have to talk about it, you know, especially if I'm going to be home alone with your children.
Oh yeah.
Or you're going to be home alone with my children. You know, these are things you need to talk about. I'm not going to sit, because if you don't want me to discipline your child, okay. I sit home. I let little Johnny run rampant.
Long as the fire.
In her house.
You come on. I say, like I said, don't get me wrong. I'm not talking about he's going to do this in my house. But if we're together, and let's say we're dating, and we've been together and we're around each other, children, we trust each other. That's how we are. I'm going to go to the store. I'll be back. I'm going out. Mm-hmm. We'll tell her, okay. Little Johnny's upstairs watching TV. Okay. As long as you know that I'm taking care, as long as you know that if Johnny get out of pocket, I'm going to put the paws on him, we good. But if you got a problem with that, okay. You want me to watch him? Yeah. Johnny can do whatever he want to do. And when you come home, you can be like, what happened here?
Where's Johnny?
Johnny happened here. Johnny happened here.
Oh, Lord.
Now, I say that, and I say it funny, because speaking personally, if I'm in a relationship, like, I cannot be in a relationship where I'm going to be around these children if I'm going to be around them that much, and I have no say-so.
Right.
I'm not saying that what I say goes all the time, but I'm going to have some say-so. And same thing if you're around my child that much. You're going to have some say-so in what goes on. And there's not going to be any, he shouldn't do this, so don't he can't do it. Because it's going to be a co-op. It's going to be, we're working together.
I don't know.
Well, I'm going to read a text we just got. Suppose the husband is not a good influence for your son. Some women are bringing in the wrong kind of man into the house.
That's a whole nother show.
Stop that. Well, you know what? You can stop that right there. You brought the wrong kind of
and
man
into
your
gonna
house.
That's what you're going to get. You're going to get the wrong type of
energy.
Yeah,
that's a whole other show.
And let's face it. If you brought the wrong kind of man into your house, you need to get the wrong kind of man out of your house.
And yep, that's what you do.
Yeah, but what I was going to say was, I had to get it together. If you don't, even if you're in, let's just say you at her house, like you said, right? And you don't discipline this child, you let him, you trying to teach her a lesson. As it gets older, though, like you said, it'll be too late at some point. He's going to disrespect you because you just weren't, I just couldn't sit idly. In a relationship that I was in, it would be the cause of a rift because I would be like, no, this just ain't going to
work. That relationship is not going to work. Yeah. It's just not going to work. Right. And if I'm there for the moment, I'm there for the moment.
Right.
And then when it gets to the point where I'm done with dealing with this nonsense, I'm gone.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? If I'm in for a penny, in for a pound, then we got to talk about this.
Mm-hmm.
If I'm just there for the moment, and if I come in and I see from the jump that this is how it's going to be, I'm going to stay around for a minute and enjoy you. And then after that, one day when I come
enjoy
over,
you.
One time after I come over, I'm going to be like, you know what?
I can't. This shit getting on my nerves.
I'm fucking done, son. I got to put his hat on and be like, it's been real.
Put that hat on backwards and walk out the door.
You can say, you know, but again, I keep saying communication is key. You have to talk about it.
Not everybody communicates offhand in relationships because you don't communicate with other people. Learning to talk in a relationship, and it stems from birth on down to that person you get in a relationship with, that has to be kind of a taught thing to discuss. Honestly, and all that kind of stuff. But that's another show, too.
But my thing is, I'm going to say how I feel, and I'm going to be honest with you. If you can't give me that return, time will tell, and then I have to make a decision at that point, whether you were honest up front, if you were just faking it to get it, or whatever. But when the child comes in, when you start bringing people around your children, to me, that's you gotta be a little smarter.
Okay, well let me say this. First of all, and this is just my belief, it's gonna be a while before I bring you around my child anyway.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not gonna meet you today, and then tomorrow have you around my child. Mm-hmm. That's just not me.
Mm-hmm.
So by the time I bring you around my child, I'm gonna have
you
a feel for you.
Yeah, you vetted her ass.
The vet process is crucial. So you're going to be able to get a feel for that. Now, you can get through all of that, and then when you finally get that interaction, it's going to be a different story. Let's face it, your child might just start acting like an asshole because he or she does not want this person around.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So now that's a whole different story. That's something you have to deal with.
Right.
But we're going to take that out of it for right now. But by the time I've decided to introduce you to my child, and then when you get around my child, you notice the interaction. And then that leads to more conversation.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that leads to conversation with you and her, or you and your child. Mm-hmm. How do you know? Did you like Miss Wanda?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Miss Wanda was nice. She's that. Oh, Miss Wanda, she seemed mean. She did. Okay. But you know what I'm saying? You say, well, why you say she seemed mean? because every time I was trying to move. Do this or that, she said it. So you know what that does? That makes me need to go back to one. And I'm not going back. You can't be talking to my son like that. But it's like, you know, we talked about it. And what's going to happen is she's going to ask. Mm-hmm. She's going to ask about, you know,
how the action went.
It's gonna come. Well, she should. If she doesn't, she doesn't really care. That's one of the things I'm saying. You notice things.
Yeah.
You know, if she doesn't
say,
did Tracy say something about me? Did little Tracy say something about me? If I don't want to say, did Lil Wanda say something about me? She's like, Lil Wanda wasn't paying you no attention.
Right, yeah.
You know, so you get the feel for that thing. And you know, it's just the way it is.
All right. Next is,
I was just playing, but would you date someone who has young children or still have children in the house?
No,
not now.
Children in the house is a different. That's different. Young children, no. My son is almost grown. Not saying that my responsibilities end when he's 18, mm-hmm. but you know, you've done the majority of the raising, right? I don't want to start all over. And it may sound ignorant, but I've heard too many horror stories about people not being a biological parent and still having to pay child support because it's the only only parent that child has known for their life.
Oh, right.
Hell no.
I've heard it.
I would blow the court up first.
I would. I wouldn't want to.
It's a lot of work with this. It was like, okay.
No. I just wouldn't want to eliminate the possibilities of her and I having a great relationship. Just on the
simple fact.
My hat's off to you.
Just on the mere fact of she has a child. Now, I do understand, you know, the problem that it could cause. I do understand the obstacles, but I wouldn't just meet you and, you know, we talk and everything, and then you say, you know, I have children. I wouldn't want to just be like, gotta go. I wouldn't want to do that now. Well, that's gotta go. I mean,
me too. But how about this? I don't know if it's a question. It's just to put it out because our time is winding down. But also, when you have a relationship and the person has kids, and then you got that other parent that comes in, and it's kind of too a little tug of war thing. I mean, you might not want nothing. You know, you're trying to raise your child together, but you're free and single to date other people. You start in a relationship and here comes whoever and is not really doing their fatherly part but they don't want the other person to do it. And then people look, I mean,
that's why I don't do it.
See,
okay.
That's just ignorance.
Deal with people with guys with children for that.
No, I'm talking about like a female. And then you have
either
your child.
Oh, either female. Either way. I don't want to deal with if I was a male, I don't want to deal with your ex's drama.
Yeah. But if you have some kind of interest, I mean, why would that?
Have an interest if I know you got little children.
See,
I don't want to deal with that.
I'm talking about even when we were mid-30s.
I've learned that.
Yeah.
And it was a mistake.
As soon as she said, I got a five-year-old,
yeah,
it's
but then
dead
it
kind of
is messed up.
See, well, that's a preference. I mean, and I understand that. But on that note, what you're talking about, the parent, I'm going to say this. I'm going to say to you, Wanda, you deal with him because if he comes to me out of pocket, it's going to get real ugly real fast.
Right.
He can approach me and say something to me anytime he wants, as long as it's respectful. And we can talk about it. He can talk about his child, how am I around. Because if my child is around somebody else, I want to know him. I want to make sure he's being respectful to my child. But even then, I'm not going to go to him and be like, let me tell you something, nigga. You do that. Because at that point, he's going to be like, why are you coming at me like that? You know what I'm saying? If he comes to me respectful and we talk about, we can have a good relationship. We're not going to go out
and
bed.
But I'm just saying, before you even get into the relationship mode, you see somebody, they fine, they cute, and then you exchange your number, you hear Johnny crying in the background, oh, you got a five-year-old, I'm done.
So, okay. Let me get
pull
this,
the cord
let me get
done.
This,
like,
let me get this straight. Let me get this straight. And I'm not knocking you
I
for your opinion.
I haven't gone 3 years down the road.
No, we're not going through. I'm saying, you're telling me, and I don't knock anybody for their opinion. You're telling me if you meet a gentleman and he's the look you want, you've talked to him a few times, and he has everything on the ball that you want, and you can see this could have great potential, and he tells you, hey, I'm going to have to call you right back. I'm going to pick up my son. And so you're going to tell me, you know what? You're going to tell him, you know what? Don't even call me back.
I'm pretty much leaning towards
that. Okay, I mean,
that.
And that's fine.
Because for me, it's not going to be a man,
Probably because of my history. You know, everybody's not the same. Some people are mature. Some people are adults. But in my mind, I'm be like, he going to be wanting to bring little Johnny over here.
But see, I wouldn't have that call that said not to call again.
That doesn't have that parental instinct from the beginning. Right. So you're talking to somebody like that. Now, for me, I don't mind little Johnny once in a while. But if he's, you know, because I know that he has the mom or whatever. Maybe he's back and forth. Okay, no problem. But it depends really how old little Johnny is.
Well, let me answer, because I have a parental instinct and I'm going to say no. It wouldn't be like, oh, don't call me back anymore. I just wouldn't answer the phone.
I just don't think I would.
As they say,
the old saying, throw the baby out with the bad water. Yeah. Just because, I mean,
I'm not trying to do that all again.
I hear you. I do understand. Mm-hmm. I do understand. Now, maybe couldn't do it with someone with an infant. That's a whole...
But now you're talking about 50 Shades of Grey now, because where do you draw the line at? Infant, 2 year olds, not too far from that. Then three years.
I'm talking about from a newborn to a toddler. That right there, that's a lot. You're going through that whole process, especially if you're talking about having a serious, long-term relationship. That's the whole
development
thing.
Development of the child.
But even if you're in kindergarten.
But even then.
They start talking back. They smart. They old.
I'm not saying it's wrong for saying.
Everybody has their own. That's why I get in the relationships that I want to get in, and everybody has their own. There is no right.
Well, I tell you, I'll say
it's a choice.
I'll say this: growing up, when I was growing up here in D.C., in the '80s, it was very hard. When I was 16 through 21, it was very hard to meet a girl who didn't have kids.
You mean in the 80s, dog? That's right now.
I'm saying it was very hard to meet someone. Nowadays, okay, you expect that someone older in their 30s or 40s, you expect for them to have children. Mm-hmm. If you met a woman right now who was not in a relationship, had no kids, single, you'd run, because you'd be like, something's wrong with her.
Though even in these 20-year-olds
like
right now have children.
But that's what I'm saying.
It's hard pressed for everybody to find somebody who does not have kids.
If you didn't have children, you think something's wrong with her.
No, I'm not saying that. I was being facetious, but no.
But you're like,
Of a man that same situation. I'd be like, what's up with him? Yeah.
I mean,
what's the closet?
My point I was making when I was younger, when I would meet girls who had kids, they would ask me, you know, how many kids, you have any kids? When I say I didn't have kids, word? You ain't got no kid. Are you working?
Yeah.
Are you working? Oh.
Yeah. Jump on it.
So I understand the...
Next thing you know, they're pregnant.
I understand the whole not wanting to deal with the kids thing. And I understand that's not because you don't like kids. I understand how it could become a problem for the... But... Again, I just don't think I would just let that ex. I would explore it. Okay. And if it, now I am at an age where I'm not gonna fake the funk. I'm not gonna pretend that it's working when it's not. Mm-hmm. It's going to be a day when I'm be like, you know, Wanda, this just not working. You know, and if the problem is with the child, you know, I'm gonna let him know that is the issue. And it might sound mean, but
it's
what it is.
Right.
So. You know,
I'm agreeing with that. So, fellas, damn, my time went quick, didn't it?
Mm-hmm.
We promised to bring you some more scripted shows and episodes. And don't forget, Venus Meets Mars every second Saturday of the month right here. And Tracy, you got some last words for us?
Yeah.
Where can we find you?
No, wordswriting.com. I'm on Facebook under Tracy Jackson. If you want to get in touch with Taylor Love, she can also put you in touch with me.
Bam!
I'm at ask_MrMicah at Twitter and Instagram. So if you need any questions, you know, send me a tweet.
All right.
All righty, and send in your suggestions, any topics and stuff you want us to discuss, let us know, and we will put it out there for you.
Oh, another
question. Go ahead, babe.
Have your viewers start putting questions on your page. Anything. It doesn't have to be on a Saturday. Anytime during the week, we're watching the page. We'll jump in there if it be for Mr. Micah, myself, Wanda, or Taylor. Just put something on the page and, you know, let us know. We'll jump right in there any day during the week. We'll give you an answer or whatever.
You got that? You heard that? Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right. So, Eric, if you could take us to break with Let's Talk and Rufus and Chaka Khan, and we'll be right back.
Was a great show. Thank you for the questions and the input we had with Venus Meets Mars. And tune in next month, second Saturday.
And our apologies to all you Johnnies out there.
Yes. So last weekend was Easter, and we had a great Easter, and everything was wonderful. I think the weather was nice that day. Everybody had on their Easter best and Easter bonnets.
I had on my Easter pajamas.
And on that note, you know, they sell so much candy. I think it's more than Valentine's Day. Everybody likes those little marshmallow peeps and chocolate-covered bunnies and jelly beans. So I got this, and the amount Americans spent on jelly beans, chocolate bunnies, and peeps was $2.2 billion.
Damn, can I get $20?
Okay. And even... the cards, Easter Bunny cards, were $695 million. But all together, it was $16.4 billion on Easter.
And I would have thought Valentine's Day would have
been. It's losing its touch. The reason why we have Easter is the resurrection of Jesus Christ. It's like Christmas, Christ being born. So now it's getting all commercialized and everything.
Like every day.
Yeah, so it's just so much. So also discovered that middle class people now.
Are we middle class?
I think we are. We have a job, so we might be in the middle of almost lower, but it just starting to get in the middle. But now, because of the economy, you middle class people can't afford one vacations. Not true. We try to go on one at least once a year, mm-hmm. try to do something. Two new cars, but you don't have to buy a new car. You can get a pre-owned that's better than new or still new. Mm-hmm. you know, the one that got repossessed from the person up the street. And then you can say, okay, I'm going to get that one. And number three is to pay off your debt. Now, I don't know any middle class person is trying to pay off all their debt, but hey. And you don't have emergency savings.
I'm getting closer to lower class as she goes down this list.
Retirement savings. Medical care and dental work. I said, wow. So that's how you are classified middle class. If you can do any of these, then you're real rich, I guess they're saying. Because middle class, yeah. So also, since the sun is out, it's springtime, everything's green, the flowers are coming up. So we need to get our energy level together and get outdoors and do things. But if you're feeling a little tired all the time, it might be one of these reasons. Go get your thyroid checked. Okay. Maybe you're having too much to drink before you go to sleep. You're dehydrated. Magnesium, you need magnesium in your system.
Okay.
Sleep apnea. Okay. And how you feel that day, maybe you just bummed out or whatever, and too much napping.
That's because of the sleep apnea and the alcohol. I mean,
okay,
gosh,
yeah.
Come on
so
now.
You try to get it in, I understand that. So, wow, it's middle of April, and I'd like to give a shout out to the birthdays, April, Tracy, Clyde, and Malacca, and my granddaughter, London. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, and my ex-husband, Benjamin Taylor.
All right. So let's see what's going on for April. The rest of the calendar is all booked up, and we're working into May. But for April, we have April 11th, which is today, Venus meets Mars. Mm-hmm. April 18th is starting the In Your Eyes segment again. We have Boys to Bow Tie. So we can't wait for BJ to come on. He's going to tell us all about his organization and everything and how this came to be. He's going to teach us how to tie a bow tie. So that day, go get your bow tie so you can learn with us. And, you know, that's the trend. I see a lot of men now wearing bow ties. And it's very professional and classy. So I like that. And on April 25th is Cinderella Cares, Fighting Lung Cancer Through the Gift of Laughter. So they're going to be on the show. And then that following evening at Fire Station 1 in Silver Spring, they're having a benefit for lung cancer. You can go online for tickets. I think it's Eventbrite. Tickets. Taylor and myself will be there. Some of the proceeds will go towards lung cancer organization. So hope to see you then. And we're going to get out and enjoy this beautiful weather we have. It's still a little windy, but it'll get better. So anything else you want to add to today?
I am good. And you guys have a wonderful weekend. And we'll see you again next Saturday for In Your Eyes segment with Boys to Bow Ties.
Okay.
Smooches. me that you love me, yeah.
Tell me something, baby.
Tell me that.